All right, we'll get to that sports highlights of Ronaldo in a short while from now. First, it's Make Me Your Mayor, our feature as we build up to the local government elections. Going to try and speak to as many mayoral candidates as we can ahead of the 1st of November. This morning, Al Jamar, mayoral candidate for the city of Cape Town, joining us all the way from the mother city as well. Let's try and find out what difference it's going to be making as we head up to the 1st of November this year. And so good to have you with us. Let's take a look at what you're actually planning, Ghanief Hendricks. What are you hoping to do differently in the city of Cape Town? Why are people going to put their mark next to you?
Look, if the ANC also votes for me as mayor, then it's not a pipe dream. And that is why some of the things that we will be do differently is to promote and support densification in formerly white suburbs. We also want to introduce informal trading hubs in white suburbs. That goes against what the other mayors most probably are going to do, and that is that they want to prevent black, colored, Indian, African creep into white suburbs. I'm also going to push for full employment of matriculants. As you know, that unemployed matriculants who don't go to university through the public works program can get jobs. And now the president has released a lot of opportunities as well for matriculants to assist teachers. I just feel that the city of Cape Town should guarantee full employment for all matriculants as we are nearly there. And that will be a step for full employment in a city where there's a lot of poverty and no jobs. We are very passionate about sewage pollution of waterways. I managed to get awards against the city of Cape Town from the public protector, from human rights, from the director of environmental enforcement. But unfortunately, the MEC, who is a DA person, on appeal turns down all these determinations. So we are going to try and lodge complaints at the police stations in terms of the NEMA Act to jail officials who pollute our rivers, who pollute our oceans, who cause diseases of our snook, and also our children who play with on making sand castles. They are poisoned by the sewage that the city pours into rivers, purely poorly treated. So that is a high priority for us. And also we want to reverse the situation where Cape Town is the drunk capital of the world. They want from South Africa means they want to reinvent apartheid. And anyone who wants to reinvent apartheid for me is a racist.
And just very briefly, I don't imagine then in the last 20 seconds I have with you, Mr. Hendricks, you'll work as a coalition with the DA. Who would you work in a coalition with if you were forced
to? We will work with the DA and we will work with the ANC as long as they give me the mayoral chain. So as you know, we hope that the gap between the ANC and the DA will be narrowed because the ANC can now have PR councillors. They put up a lot of candidates from the colored and the Indian community. They always used to just put up blacks. These people are community workers. So the chances are that the ANC will do well with them. People won't vote for the ANC. They will vote for these candidates who's given excellence, who've served good causes over the years. So we hope that the ANC, the gap will be narrow, because that will give Al Jamar an opportunity to have the balance of power. We are targeting 15 seats in the city of Cape Town. Yes, we have two now, but we have 1,000 candidates all over South Africa. We are in 30 municipalities in 7 provinces. Our footprint has increased tenfold from the last elections. Our votes increased from 13,000 to 40,000. And now in the third election we're contesting, we are looking at substantially more. Some say 1 million, but I'm going to go for 100,000.
Mr. Hendricks, and to the residents of the city of Cape Town, you now have that option as well come the 1st of November. Ghanief Hendricks, Al Jamar Party leader, telling us what they stand for and what they won't stand for, it seems, in the city of Cape Town on Make Me Your Mayor.